someone walks through our first doors was really an important part of this whole idea of what we need to build, how we need to build it, what it needs to look like. Everything we have done, we have tried to incorporate some kind of a statement, not just building a functional building. And we wrestled with it for a little while, but we were pretty clear about the direction. We didn't want to build a multi-purpose functional building, although that's important and it needs to be functional. We were creating this holy space, and what our hope was is as people come into this, to the doors of our church, there's a transcendent feel that maybe you don't feel in other places, that your eyes are drawn upward, that you are surrounded by symbols that are ancient, but yet in a modern building. That you have an awareness, there's a presence and a spirit about the place that perhaps is unique from other types of architecture. But even the way it's laid out, it's a communal building. We wanted people to be engaged with one another, to have spaces where they could begin to talk, have conversations, shared experiences, and that's really important to our work in ministry. And that initial feeling when they walk through the door is incredibly important. In fact, we tell our guests, you'll know in the first 10 minutes whether or not this is a place that you feel like you can make a home and belong and find people who will support you and be around you. And sure, it's part of the friendliness of the people, but it's the invitation of a building that seems to be a place where God is present and people are active and engaged in a way that's very positive and meaningful. I think in this day and age, there's a cultural disconnect to that which is holy and sacred. And I don't say that in a condescending manner. I just think it's our responsibility to create those spaces and connect people to God or higher power and a presence beyond just what we normally experience. And the sanctuary by design really incorporates some pretty key elements. So it's a modern building, but it's surrounded by some ancient symbols, and we've incorporated part of our past, which means you're standing in a sanctuary less than 2 years old, but you're also surrounded by stained glass window that dates back to 50 years. The sanctuary is that place where when you walk in, and we've had this experience, which I think is remarkable, is people begin to quiet their voices, and it's the building that does that, and I think that's a pretty remarkable reaction. The building is more than a building. I mean, when we talk about a church, it's really our place of ministry, and the goal for our church was never just to build a building. It was to build a building so that we could reach further and deeper into the community for the work that we're trying to do. And the building is just a huge asset and a wonderful achievement. I really appreciate the thought that the architects have put into it. They listened carefully. We went through several different redesigns until we all felt like this is exactly what we wanted. So I have to give them a lot of credit. They were very attentive. And there's a sort of coded language of religion that's not always understandable to people outside of it. And they got it, and they understood it, and they incorporated it into the building.
Brought to you by Honfeld Hoffer Stanford Architects, celebrating their 50th anniversary of transforming Fort Worth and all of North Texas.